Let's pray. Blessed Lord, we thank you this hour. We glorify your name for your love and care. We thank you for coming to save us in the world, and we thank you because you have given us examples of what we will do, and you have given us the way to enter into your kingdom. And Lord, as you have taught us, not because we are sinful to come and be baptized and be washed, but you have given us examples that we will follow so that we will be able to make it in life. And Lord, as we look at your word, open our eyes. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen. Amen.
The baptism of Jesus. Christ's first public appearance after he had long lived obscurely in Nazareth was the baptism that we are looking at this morning. In the Markan Gospel, we read this morning, we have a brief account of Christ's baptism. And this is what we are following. First of all, I want to look at two important things, or three important things that Jesus Christ showed us here. The first thing is that he humbled himself. He humbly owned God the Father by coming to the baptism of John. So by coming to the baptism of John, he was following the steps that God the Father had given unto him. There are basically two things I want us to engage in this one. This is about relationship. The relationship between Christ and the Father, and also the Spirit. We are trying to look at this in this in the message. So though we see in the Hebrew word for God, the Hebrew word for God is Elohim. And as we read in the first lesson, Genesis chapter 1, verses 1 through 5, we saw the story of creation, and that was telling us that God created heaven and the earth. And God who created heaven and the earth, we see there that the Hebrew word for that God is Elohim. And that means mightiness, the mightiness of God, and the plurality of God in unity. So we see that in God, God is shown as being plural, and yet God is one. And this is where the doctrine of Trinity is perfected, and we also continue to see this in the scripture. Though Christ was perfectly pure and unspotted, yet he submitted himself to be washed as if he had been polluted. He was not a sinful man, he had no sin, but because of us, to give an example of what we will do. So he had to go through this to show us the example. So we see that he humbled himself to what the Father had ordered. The second thing is that God honorably owned Christ when he submitted to John's baptism. God honored him. And this this honor is given to him directly, so that he himself knew that this is the honor from the Father. So there are three clues to this submission. The first one is he saw the heavens opened. Thus he was owned by the Lord from heaven. He was owned to be the Lord of lords, to be the King of kings, right from heaven. So he had a message from heaven. And Matthew says it in this way. The heavens were opened to him. The heavens were opened to him. But in the Markan's expression, Mark says he saw the heavens opened. So they are saying the same thing. But you will see that Jesus Christ saw the heavens opened, and the heavens was opened to him. And this is showing that the Father was really in line with him. So many have the heavens open to receive them, but they do not see it. You know, when the heavens are open to you and you do not see, how will you be able to answer? So we need to really move close to the Lord so that when our heavens are open, we will be able to see and we'll be able to draw the blessings of God for us. Many people are still in the dark. They cannot see heavens being open to them. And this is very pathetic. We need to open our eyes, the spiritual eyes, to be able to see what God has for us. So he saw the Spirit like a dove descended upon him. That is the second one. He heard a voice from heaven which approved of him. You are my beloved, in whom I am well pleased. But Jesus Christ, the Holy Spirit, God the Father, we see the Trinity. And this is what we have as a church, as the Church of Christ, the established Church of Christ. We have the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit coming in unity to be one. And Elohim, God, God in plurality. Not only that, God in mightiness. God is mighty, mighty. And as we have it as El Shaddai. El Shaddai means the mighty God. So the mighty God, in the Godhead, we have the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit. The significance of the baptism is that when we confess our sins, we come to the Lord, the next thing is that the Lord will wash us with the Word of God. And when we are washed, we become members of the body of Christ. We make an open manifestation of these by going into water to be baptized. So those who have been baptized, we need to remember this all the time, that we are not just ordinary people. We have been redeemed, and we are the redeemed of the Lord, and we should continue to do the will of God. And God help us in Jesus' name.
Beloved, baptism is more than just going into water. It is an affirmation that you have turned away from the sinful nature of the world. You are now turning to Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior. You have accepted Jesus to be your Lord and Savior. You have confessed all your unworthiness and you have made the decision to follow Jesus Christ. When you have done this and now you present yourself for baptism, then that baptism is meaningful and you are saying to the world, I am no longer for you, I am for Jesus. So it is for us to confess Jesus as our Lord and Savior and to take our cross and follow Jesus. This is what baptism means. It means that we are dead to sin. We are dead to the worldly systems. And we are now focusing on Jesus Christ as our Lord and Savior. We are dead when we are buried in water. It typifies that we are dead to sin. And when we rise up from water, we are saying that we have risen with Jesus Christ to live a life that Jesus Christ has given to us. So, my brother, my sister, my friends, it is very important to take this baptism as it is, that we are baptized as the believers who have confessed our sins, who have come to know the Lord. And when we do this, we know that we have begun a new journey. And when we begin this journey, we continue to fellowship with other believers. We continue to pray. We continue to read the scripture, to obey the word of God, these precepts. And we continue to live by faith. And we continue to ask whatever we need from the Lord. And the Lord will continue to meet all our needs. So my brothers, my sisters, those of us who have been baptized, are we living according to the way the Lord has given us? We need to retrace our steps back and begin to live the life that is worthy unto the Lord. Thank you for watching this video, and I pray that God will continue to establish His word in your life.